Hello everybody, this is Jeff from the library again, and today we're going to talk about how to use Google, specifically Google Advanced Search. So, you know, my thing, I'm always telling you to use the databases, but if you're going to use Google, a lot of people don't know about how to use Google Advanced Search, which makes it a lot more reliable. So let me just go up here and show you. When we go into Google, these days it's not as easy to get to Google's Advanced Search as it used to be. Type this right. So when we bring up google.com, there used to be a little advanced search button right here, which isn't there anymore, so you can't go directly into it. And I have mine set up for this automatic searching thing, which I really don't like, but this is the new deal. But if you start typing in something here, as soon as it comes up like this, I just typed in A, it starts trying to search for you. You can click advanced search over here, and then you can do your advanced searching, which we're going to talk more about. Now, because this is kind of annoying, you can also, let me show you some other ways you could get there. You could also just type in up at the top of your thing here, google.com, and then I think it's type in, yeah, advanced_search. It'll take you there. Or if you're really annoyed with this, as I kind of am, if you go from the library website, I have a link that'll take you directly into Google Advanced Search. So beneath the databases, citation assistance, down here under more resources, click there, that'll take you directly into Google Advanced Search. Okay, so with Google Advanced Search, we can use Google just to search whatever we want. Instead of searching everything, all the .coms and everything, what I really like about it is right down here, search within a site or domain, we can set it to search the types of websites we would like to search for. So let's say, for instance, I was going to type in here bilingual, and we're here with this exact wording or phrase. Let me type in bilingual education, and instead of searching just everything out there, I'm going to type down here .edu. This means it's only going to search education web pages, which means education or web pages put up by educational institutions, so universities, schools, things like that. And it still found a lot, 524,000, but every web page here is going to be sponsored by some type of educational institution. Okay, so hopefully, you know, we're going to find things a lot more reliable, people who actually study these things, instead of just every .com in the world where you're kind of not sure what's out there. We could also do this for .gov, for government websites. Let me just show you, I went pretty quickly on there. So I just typed .gov down in here in the search within a site or domain, kept my bilingual education. Now I'm only going to look for websites that have bilingual education and they're sponsored by some kind of government agency. So we have all kinds of just government web pages here. That's from, it looks like the New York State Department of Ed. Okay. And let's see, we could even get more specific with this. Let's say, for instance, you want to just search the Colorado Department of Education. And I know from looking them up that their website is cde.state.co.us. But if you didn't know that and you wanted to figure out what their website was, you could go over here and just Google them the regular way. Type in Colorado Department, and I don't like this thing where they're trying to fill in the gaps for me. I don't like that. I'm old-fashioned. Okay, Colorado Department of Education. I could copy and paste their URL. I could copy that, cde.state.co.us. I'm going to copy that, go back into my advanced search, and put it down here. So now I'm just going to be looking at web pages from the Colorado Department of Education for bilingual education. Okay, and it found 137, but it's really specific. So right now, I'm basically using the Colorado Department of Education as a database to search just within their website for pages on this. We could get more specific. Let me go back here. How about, let's see, file type. Right now, I'm just kind of searching for everything. And, you know, what did it do with all my stuff? Let me click on advanced search again. Okay, so I've still got my stuff in here. Let's say, file type. Right now I'm just looking for all kinds of web pages. What if I set this to PDF? Now if it searches for PDF, that's going to be a scan of a page. So usually that's going to be something that was published in print first, or is just a little more official. So we might find some journal articles in here now, different kinds of forms and things. So now we're just going to look for PDFs. And again, this is just from the Colorado Department of Education. And so now you're seeing, getting things related to standards. You're getting things that are a little more formal now, because they were, a lot of these were first published in print, and then were scanned in here. So you can just see how specific we can get with Google Advanced Search. We can tell it only to search exactly what we want to search. And a lot of times that's the problem on the internet, is you're just finding so many millions of web pages. You have no idea what you're looking at. You don't know where it came from. You're just looking at a sea of everything. This Advanced Search is how we can tell it only to look for certain things. Let me change that back to any format. Now also I could go down here, and there's some other limits we could set on here. If we click right here, date, usage, rights, region, and more, I could tell it only look for this phrase that I have up here, bilingual education in CDE, Colorado Department of Education web pages. Only bring up web pages where that phrase is in the title of the page. Right now it's looking anywhere in the page. What if it's just in the title of the page? Then click Advanced Search again. And see, it didn't find anything with that just in the title. That's okay. Let me go back here and say, what if I look for a different website? How about the Department of Education, the general, the federal, the big, the U.S. Department of Education. And I know from searching for them earlier, their website is www.ed.gov. Let's see if we find anything there with bilingual education just in the title, because I still have that limit set here. In the title of the page, bilingual education, we're only going to look at the U.S. Department of Education. Advanced search. They found one thing there. We open that up, we see bilingual education is in the title. Okay. Now we could go back, maybe this is a little too specific. Maybe I should just say just general.gov web pages. We've still got our thing here for just in the title of the page. Just be aware that stays on even if you don't see it. So there we have 2040 in general web pages. They're all government web pages, but notice now they all have bilingual education in the title of the page. Now we could go back and you keep changing your limits on here. How about just PDFs? Click my advanced search again. Now all these are going to be PDFs from government web pages. And notice how you can tell it was something scanned in or digitally put in here, but it looks like a regular page as opposed to just a regular HTML web page. And I like PDFs because they're really easy to work with. You click here to print it or to download it. They're really easy to download and save, as opposed to regular HTML pages, which are a little tricky to save. So that's an overview of how to use this. Let's go back here and do some different kinds of things. So we've just been looking for education. Let me set my limits all back to the default here. Title of the page, I'm going to change that back to anywhere in the page. What about something even more specific? Let's say we're looking for bilingual education. How about University of Northern Colorado? I want to look in their website, see if they have anything on this. And I know from searching earlier that it's unco.edu. Going to do a search here. And there's some things there. So these are all by the phrase bilingual education, and it has to be a PDF still from UNC. Maybe the PDF was too specific. Let me go in here and take that off, any kind of a file. There we go. And I could keep, again, making this more and more specific if I wanted to. Maybe, since we have quite a few there from UNC, let me go in here and put this in the title. Okay, so now let's see if there are pages where that phrase is in the title. The phrase is in the title. We're only looking from UNC, any kind of format. Let's see what happens here. There we go. We had 5 results. But it's getting really specific to exactly kind of what we want. So you're probably noticing I'm using a lot of the same techniques I use with EBSCO and the different databases to narrow things down. So this is how you can kind of turn Google into kind of like your own little database. Let me go back here. Let's search something completely different. Let me take those off there, and I think I still have my title thing set here. And it makes it pretty fun. This is a pretty fun way to use Google, and it makes it, you have so much more control over what you're doing. What about, let's look at the EPA, the Environmental Protection Agency, epa.gov. That's a huge website. So within the epa.gov, what about pages that have to do with aerosol? Remember that used to be the big thing when I was a kid, was you weren't supposed to use aerosol cans because they're bad for the environment? Let me see what's up with that these days. Okay, 384,400, or wait, 384,000 about, just from the EPA. That's just from the Environmental Protection Agency's website. So that website in itself is like a huge database. And that's just from that one website. Imagine if you just Googled aerosol with no limit set on what you were looking at, it would just be overwhelming. Let's go back here again. We could do our thing. Let's say, and these are, you know what, you kind of notice the things I like to use. I like to narrow it down by title. You could probably figure out other things you would like to use this for if you do it for a while. Just in the title takes it down to 4,240. Just out of curiosity, how many of these might be PDFs? Now you could look for other things. How about PowerPoints? Can you look for any PowerPoints to do with aerosol from the EPA? There you go. There's two PowerPoints we could find online. That might help you put together a presentation. If I open up this here, this is a PowerPoint stored online. So it's searching my computer, trying to find PowerPoint, trying to link it up here. And here we go. We've got a PowerPoint there. Pretty neat. So there's so many different things you can do with this. Let me go back here and do another one. And I'm just about done here. It's just all of a sudden I'm having fun with this, and I can't quite stop now. What about the census? The census is a great place to look. www.census.gov. This is the U.S. Census. And let's look for information for, let's say, the Asian population of the U.S. Let's look in the census. We're just going to use the census website now. And let me take off the PowerPoint. Any format. Do I still have my thing on for title? Yep. Got to be careful of that. That'll stay on even if you don't see it. Okay, so just looking in the U.S. Census webpage for information about the Asian population. There we go. Asian and Pacific Islander population. This would be a great place to find statistics. Let's open this up here and see what kind of tables they have in here. So they have all these really specific tables you could go into. I'm going to open this up. These are all Excel spreadsheets. We just got all these numbers here we could find. It's terrific. And this kind of thing would be really hard to find like in an EBSCO database. But the census has all this data on there. It's just kind of hard to find unless you kind of know what you're doing. Okay, let's go back here and we could go back here to advanced search again, and you know, we could do the same thing again, all those other limits I set on it. But I think this gives you a good idea for how to use Google Advanced Search, and basically this transforms Google into a database where you have complete control over whatever you look for, and it should make your results a lot more reliable than just going to .coms and things. Not that there's anything wrong with .com, but anyone can set up a .com webpage regardless of their credentials or any fact checking. If it's a government web page or an education web page, generally speaking, it's going to be a lot better. Now also, we could do .orgs. Those are good. .orgs are nonprofits, and I could search, let's see, global warming. What kind of things are out there in .orgs, nonprofits? Now let's say your teacher has told you, well, I don't want to see anything from Wikipedia. Well, Wikipedia is a .org. So you could say here, don't show pages that have any of these unwanted words. So I could search all the .orgs except for Wikipedia. So I'm going to say, no, I don't want to see Wikipedia. And it's going to search everything, all the .orgs, all the nonprofits, except for Wikipedia. So that's a pretty cool thing there. So, you know what? I could go on forever with this. This is so fun. But I think this gives you an idea how to use this. As always, let me know if you have any questions. This is Jeff signing off.